It's nighttime in the big city. A school teacher drinks alone. They're finally tearing down the old shoe factory. This is Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Welcome once again to Theme Time Radio Hour, and this week's show is prepared under the strictest security standards. In other words, we got everything locked up tight, because that's what we're talking about this week, locks. And not just locks, but also the corresponding keys. That's right, we're going to be locked up, locked out, keyed up, wound up. We're going to be talking about church keys and skate keys. We'll listen to the key of C and learn about the key to good living. There'll be lip locks, Loch Ness, time locks, and vapor locks. Before the end of it, we might even get the key to the city. So I hope y'all locked and loaded and sitting by your radio. We're going to start it all off old school. We told you about Bessie Smith. She got her start with Ma Rainey. I took her under her wing and coached her. But Bessie soon outshone her. The queen of the blues singers is Bessie Smith, lock and key.
You and me will have a terrible falling out. No one at the barber's ball will know what it's all about. They'll hear a shot and see you duck, and when the smoke is cleared away, then the band will crawl from behind the stand, and then you hear me say, when I get home, I'm gonna change my lock and key. When you get home, you'll find an awful change in me. If I don't change my mind, another thing you will find, that your baby maybe has got another baby on the Pullman line. You did your stuff, so get yourself another home. I said it long enough, so pack your little trunk and roam. I used to love you once, but you took and made a fool out of me. Oh, when I get home, I'm gonna change this old lock and key. Take off that suit I bought you. Give me that hat and that red vest too. Take off my watch. Give me my ring. I want them shoes and everything. You just got to be the lady's squeeze. Well, let them squeeze you in your BVD. If you say much, I'll shoot them all. I'll shoot them all if I hear you call. Cause when I get home, I'm gonna change my lock and key. When you get home, you'll find a place where home used to be. And if I don't change my mind, another thing you will find, that your baby maybe has got another baby just as good in time. You cheated on me, and that's the thing that made me so. I change that key, I get myself another dough. You're homeless as a flea. Cause when I get home, I'm gonna change my lock and key. Believe me.
That was big voice, big bone Bessie Smith and lock and key. If Bessie's gonna change the locks, it might not work, as she's gonna need a restraining order. Webster's defines a restraining order as a legal order issued against an individual to restrict or prohibit access or proximity to another specified individual. Doesn't have to be a human either. In 2006, a judge in New York issued the first ever restraining order on behalf of a dog. That was a man who had been feuding with the dog's owner. Well, you know how it is. You can't go after the man, so you kick the dog. Well, this dog had a lawyer and got himself a restraining order. Smart dog.
Thank you.
Sonny Boy Williamson is a link between country blues and rock and roll. By the mid-30s, he was working in the Delta with artists like Robert Johnson, Robert Nighthawk, and Robert Jr. Lockwood. I guess he only worked with Roberts. He made a lot of records on his own, both for trumpet and chess. Sonny Boy was married to Howlin' Wolf's sister, Mary Burnett, and also sold a whole lot of flour on his King Biscuit radio show. Here's Sonny Boy, and he's looking for the key to your door.
Yes, it's just one thing, baby, I really want you to do. Woman, you know I'm in love with you, and I've been trying to find out what you gonna do. I'm begging you, begging you, if you don't know. All I want from you is the key to your door. You know I called you yesterday, a quarter after nine. A quarter after nine. But the landlady told me, Sonny Boy, that woman won't cause you to lose your mind. Called my baby back 15 after four. I called my baby back 15 after four. I'm just asking you, please, please, darling, give me the key to your door.
Sonny Boy Williamson, kind of a crazy march, the key to your door. Sound like they're all playing in different keys there for a minute. Personally, I don't think it was actually the key to your door that he was looking for. Maybe he was looking for the key to a chastity belt. Chastity belts were worn by women to stop them from fooling around when their men would be away for long periods of time. Supposedly, they got their start in the times of knights and crusaders. The oldest design for one dates from the 16th century. Slightly more recently, in 2004, a 40-year-old British woman set off an airport metal detector with a steel chastity belt. Her husband had forced her to wear it. She was going on a holiday in Greece, and he didn't quite trust her. She was allowed to board the plane wearing it. People say they're coming back? I don't know. Some girls you can't even get to wear underwear.
There are more than 30 rooms in all. In the old days, they made a separate key for each room. For the owner, they made a skeleton key. This will open every door.
There's a couple of things you notice about a lot of the artists we play here on Theme Time Radio Hour. Many of them are from Louisiana, and also many of them made their first musical instrument themselves. We've talked about Gus Cannon with his griddling raccoon skin. We talk about some cigar box guitars. And our next artist, Adam Herbert, was not only born in Louisiana, but he also made his first fiddle out of a chocolate box and screen wire. He was a good businessman at a young age. At 13, he started playing in house dances, charging 10 cents for men to get in. Women were admitted free. That's good business. In the mid-50s, he formed the Country Playboys. The accordion player in the group was Clay B. Rashad, who was Dalton Rashad's father. You can hear him on this record, on the Swallow record label. It translates as, "Open the door," but you might know it better as "Ouvre ses portes." Open the door. Adam Herbert and the Country Playboys. Here on Theme Time Radio Hour, we're talking about locks and keys. Our next artist, mother was a singer. She only sang church songs and never liked her son singing secular music. At the age of 17, Jimmy Nelson hopped on a train for the West Coast. He went into a club and heard Big Joe Turner.
I play the blues so low down.
It blew his mind. Big Joe became Jimmy Nelson's close friend and drinking buddy. As a matter of fact, on some nights, Joe would get so tanked, he couldn't perform. Jimmy went on and performed as Joe Turner. Jimmy recorded for the Baha'i Brothers, and his 1952 session was recorded in a bathroom for the acoustics. Sure sounds like it on this record. Here's Jimmy Nelson, Unlock the Lock.
I love you in the morning, I love you noon and night, and if you let me in, I'll be sweet and nice. Oh, please, unlock the lock and let me in. Been boys, baby. And I'm all free of sin. Don't look now, but my love is coming down. The way I love you would make a rabbit hug a hound. Oh, please. Unlock the lock and let me in. Been with the boys, baby, and I'm all free of sin. Down crying shame, I can't go out at all. And when I come back home, I can't get in at all. Oh, please. Unlock the lock and let me in. Been with the boys, baby, and I'm all free of sin. You can't boss my money and lock me out too. My mind tells me I'm just as fine as you. Oh, please. Unlock the lock and let me in. Been with the boys, baby, and I'm all free of sin.
That was Jimmy T, 99 Nelson, and Unlock the Lock. One guy who didn't need you to unlock the lock was Harry Houdini. He was born Eric Weiss, and he worked as a locksmith's apprentice. In 1904, he escaped from a set of handcuffs that were called unpickable. They had taken a London locksmith 5 years to make, but they were no match for Houdini. He performed the famous milk can escape, where he was locked in a metal milk can filled with water. He did a trick that he called the upside down, but was more familiarly known as the Chinese water torture, Cell Illusion. It was hung upside down and lowered into a water-filled glass tank, which was then locked. It seemed like Houdini could escape from anything, but one thing even he couldn't escape from was the Grim Reaper. He died in 1926, and legend is he died on stage. He often made the claim that he could withstand a blow from anyone to his stomach. He had just finished a performance and was lying down in his dressing room. A student from nearby McGill University came in and hit Houdini in the solar plexus before he could tense up his muscles. Supposedly, this blow ruptured his appendix and killed him. However, most researchers believe that that's malarkey, and he actually ignored the symptoms of appendicitis and died from the complications resulting. Lots of legends about Houdini. Some people even say that he was a spy. One guy who knows about that is Retzo Sloman, the guy in the Kinky Friedman books, who wrote all about Houdini in his book The Secret Life of Houdini. Houdini is one of those names that's been absorbed into the language. I mean, how many times have you heard someone say, he pulled the real Houdini? I know I've said that a number of times, but I'm getting off the subject. Retzo, tell us about Houdini.
Thanks for asking, Bob. Well, in the book, we uncover evidence that Houdini was a spy, in that he was doing surveillance missions for William Melville, who was an inspector at Scotland Yard and later went on to head the MI5, which was British Secret Service. Houdini had a unique ability to penetrate places. Locks would not defeat him. And he was, according to Melville's diary, sending back information that was so valuable that Melville, when he got it, would bring it directly to the British government. And we think he was doing the same thing for the Secret Service, although we don't have the actual smoking gun documents.
Thanks, Ratso. This is Theme Time Radio Hour, Locks and Keys. And here's kind of a modern update of the Bessie Smith song we heard earlier from another high-spirited, strong-hearted woman. And again, she's from Louisiana. Her father was a literature professor and a published poet. They moved frequently, and growing up, the family lived in Louisiana, Mississippi, Georgia, Arkansas, Mexico City, and Santiago, Chile. Took a little bit from each city and cooked up her own personal style. Time magazine called her America's Best Songwriter in 2002. I guess I was out of town. Here's Lucinda Williams and Change the Locks. Sound like she changed more than a lock on her front door. Changing everything. That's Lucinda Williams here on Theme Time Radio Hour. We're talking about locks and the keys that fit them. If your key won't fit the door, you might have to pick the lock. Some people who pick locks try to improve their sense of touch and sensitivity by rubbing sandpaper across their fingers. This was immortalized in a song sung by Bing Crosby and written by Gus Edwards by a famous guy named Jimmy Valentine. I'm going to play a chorus of it for you, and then I'm going to tell you all about it.
Look out, look out, look out for Jimmy Valentine. For he's a pal of mine, a sentimental crook. With a touch that lingers in his sandpapered fingers, he can find the combination of your pocketbook.
That was Bing Crosby singing about Jimmy Valentine. A sentimental crook with a touch that lingers. Was that real Jimmy Valentine? Well, it's hard to say. See, there was this guy named William Sidney Porter. He worked as a teller in a bank down in Texas. He was charged with taking some money. No one knows whether or not he actually did it, but one thing they do know, he jumped bail and was caught and sent to jail. In jail, he met a man named Jimmy Valentine. So he says, might be fiction. Because you see, when Porter got out of jail in 1901, he moved to New York and became the famous short story writer, O. Henry. He was known for his surprise endings. In 1909, he wrote a story called A Retrieved Reformation, and it featured a character named Jimmy Valentine. In the story, Valentine got out of jail and decided to go straight. But first, he needed some money, so he was going to crack one more safe and one more bank. But when you know it, he met a girl, and they fell in love. She was the daughter of the bank president. But Jimmy played it straight, and her father took a liking to him. He was going to introduce Jimmy to everyone in town at a party where he was going to show off his bank's new time lock safe. Well, Jimmy's girlfriend's sister was there, and she had two little kids. They were playing hide and seek right in front of the safe. One of the little girls ran in there to hide, and the other one slammed the door shut. There was no way to open the safe for 24 hours, and it was nowhere near that amount of air in there. You know, Jimmy Valentine watched. He had to make a decision. He might be able to open the safe, but if he did, everyone would know he was a safe cracker. They couldn't let the little girl die. He rubbed the tips of his fingers, turned the tumblers, and opened that lock. The girl came out safe and sound. Jimmy was ready to take his punishment and be shunned. But a man stepped out of the crowd. It was a detective who had put Jimmy in jail 2 years ago. Jimmy walked over to him and said, "You saw it all. Now you must do your duty." The detective looked at him and said, "Yes, I saw it all. I thought I recognized you, but I see you made a big mistake. You are a better man than the man I thought you were." The story of Jimmy Valentine.
Whatever you want to lock in, lock out, lock up, or lock down, remember, master locks are tough under tough conditions. Tough under pressure. Tough under fire.
Early in tonight's broadcast, we played Jimmy Nelson. We told you how he was friends with Big Joe Turner. Well, the next singer wasn't exactly friends with Big Joe. He was kind of his rival. He was considered the other big jump blues singer in his day. His career didn't have a long life, Joe's did, but in the short moment he was there, no one shone brighter. Winona Judd got her name from this singer. Her name Winona is the feminine version of the little herd name Winoni. Back in the 40s, you couldn't turn on the radio without hearing Winoni, Mr. Blues Harris. Here's one of his recordings for the King record label, "Somebody Done Changed the Lock on My Door."
Well, somebody done changed. Yes, done changed the lock on my door. Somebody done changed. Yes, done changed the lock on my door. Well, the key that I got don't fit that same lock no more. Well, I come home this morning about 10:30. I pulled it out, but I couldn't stick it in. Somebody done changed. Yes, done changed the lock on the door. Well, the key that I got don't fit that lock no more. Well, I went around to my window to see what I could see. Someone was in my bed, and I know it wasn't me. Somebody done changed. Yes, done changed the lock on the door. Well, the key that I got don't fit that lock no more. Well, then I walked down the street looking where I used to go. She's got a mean little jitterbug, and I can't go there no more. Somebody done changed. Yes, done changed the lock on my door.
That I was buying Ernie Harris, and somebody done changed the lock on my door. What's that, Tex? Someone needs to talk to me? On line two? All right. Hello, caller. You're on the air. What's your name and where are you calling from?
Yeah, my name is Tim Ziegler, calling from Champaign-Urbana, Illinois.
Oh, that's beautiful country. What can I do for you, Tim?
Yeah, I've been listening to the show all day, and that song you just played, Somebody Done Changed the Lock on My Door, well, you know, you told everyone it was on the King record label, and I went to Wikipedia, and sorry to tell you, it was on Apollo Records.
Huh. What do you know? You're probably right, Tim. You know, sometimes we tell you who wrote the song, what kind of music it is, who else recorded it. But you know, sometimes we don't get it right. I mean, it's important to remember, this isn't a classroom here. There's music we're playing. There's music of the field, of the pool hall, the back alley crap game, the bar room and the bedroom. We don't want to make it dusty and academic. It's full of sweat and blood. It's like life itself. If every once in a while we get the name wrong, or we tell you it's on the wrong label, it's not going to kill anybody, Tim. Just listen to the music.
Well, I hear what you're saying, but, you know, it was on the Apollo record label.
Well, thanks for your call, Tim.
Yeah, thanks.
Well, there's no pleasing some people. That was Somebody Done Changed the Lock on My Door by Wynonie Harris on the Apollo record label. You happy, Tim? This is Theme Time Radio Hour, and we're talking about locks and keys. One guy who talked a lot about him was a comedian named Dusty Fletcher. He played in vaudeville and traveled the Chitlin' Circuit. He had a live routine that became one of the most famous records of the 40s. He'd walk out on stage with a ladder, lean against the curtain, and call up to his friend Richard. He'd locked himself out of the house, and he needed Richard to come down and open the door. Richard wasn't much help, as he was probably intoxicated. It's actually much more interesting when you hear Dusty Fletcher tell it. Let's listen to a little bit of Dusty.
Oh, so you throwed me out, huh? Well, that's all right. That ain't the first time I've been thrown out of a saloon. I know what I'd do. I'm going on home and getting me some sleep. I wonder what did Richard do with that key? When did he go to sleep with the key? Well, that's all right. I'll just wake him up and make him open the door. Open the door, Richard. That's the boy I rooms with. Open the door, Richard. I know he ain't going out nowhere, cause I got on the clothes. Open the door, Richard. And that's when I don't like to room with nobody. He don't want to open the door for me. And I owe just as much rent up here as he do.
Open the door, Richard. Open the door and let me in. Open the door, Richard.
Dusty's record reached number two on the R&B charts, but another performer named Jack McVeigh recorded a more rhythmic version and made the song a national phenomenon. By 1947, there were at least 22 versions of it. Louis Jordan did it, the Canes, the Pied Peppers. There was a group called the Yokels that sang it in Yiddish. Bob Hope and Fred Allen would just mention Richard, and the studio audience would crack up. Everyone was quoting the song the way they quote Boaz today. Here's Jack McVeigh. But open the door, Richard.
Old band's been out to the club having a little ball tonight. My friend Richard went home early, you know. He's got the only key to the house. I'm gonna have to knock on the door to see if I can get in. Open the door, Richard. See, Richard sleeps in the back room. It's kind of hard to hear. Maybe I better knock a little louder. Open the door, Richard. I don't think Richard heard me yet. Knock one more time to see what's gonna happen here.
Open the door, Richard. Open the door and let me in. Open the door, Richard. Richard, why don't you open that door? Open the door. Open the door and let me in. Open the door, Richard.
Richard?
Richard, why don't you open that door?
Richard, open up the door, man. It's cold out here in this air. Now look, there's that woman across the street looking out the window. Every time I'm late, I wonder if I, where's he been? Where has he been?
Trying to follow what's happening.
Yeah. Yes, it's me and I'm late again.
Did you hear what the lady said, Jack?
don't know what she said, Rayburn.
She said, oh, bye, if he was only bye.
I'll have to knock again. Rich has got to get up. Open up the door, Rich. Red, you got a key to my front door?
I don't have no key, Jack. I don't have a key.
Well, somebody got to get in the house some kind of way.
Well, I know he's in there.
How you know he's in there?
I can hear him breathing.
Boom. Let's knock one more time.
Richard, open up that door, man.
Maybe Richard's gone. Let's try him one more time.
She got on the clothes.
I know I got on the suit. He's got to be in there. Knock one more time.
Open the door, Richard. Open the door and let me in. Open the door, Richard. Richard, why don't you open that door? Open the door, Richard.
Richard!
Open the door and let me in. Open the door, Richard.
That was Jack McVeigh and Open the Door, Richard, a national phenomena. And listen to this. Not only were there country, polka, pop, and Yiddish versions, almost 20 years later, it was inspiring ska musicians. Listen to a tiny bit of this by Clive and Niobe. See, that song can be done any kind of way. About time for it to come back again. Maybe I'll even do it. This is Theme Time Radio Hour. Open the door, it's cold out here. You know, we had a caller before who was very concerned with the Rat record label. Whenever I sit around with other record collectors, there's always arguments about who did what song better, or sometimes even which version by the same guy is the best. You know, the version he did in 1961, or the version he did 25 years earlier when he was playing with his brother. This next song has lots of different versions. Just about all of them are good. You can hear it by Count Basie. You can hear it by Eric Clapton. You can hear it by Buddy Guy, John Hammond Jr., the Derek Trucks Band, Junior Wells, or the band. I'm not going to play it by the guy who wrote it either. I'm going to play the version that I like, the best version. Here's Little Walter singing Big Bill Brunsey's Key to the Highway.
I got the key to the highway. Built out and bound to go. I'm gonna leave here running because walking is most too slow. I'm going back to the border. Done nothing but drove a good man away from home. Give me one more kiss, mama, just before I go. But when I leave this time, girl, I won't be back no more. Way. I'm gonna roam this highway until the break of day. Well, it's so long, so long, babe, I must say goodbye. I'm gonna roam this highway until the day I die.
When the moon creeps over the mountain, honey, I'll be on my way. Little Walter, Key to the Highway. Here on Theme Time Radio Hour, we're talking about locks and keys. If you'd like to be a locksmith, there's no formal training procedure, and you don't need any certification. You can train by being an apprentice, take coursework or home study, and most training programs are under 6 months. If you do, among the things you'll learn is how to deal with cylinder locks, pin and tumbler locks, combination locks and permutation locks, electronic locks and ignition locks, Mortise locks and padlocks, bicycle locks and child safety locks, magnetic locks, warded locks, and key card locks. And in the northeastern states, bagels and locks. There's another kind of lock people wear on their heads, known as a dreadlock. A dreadlock is probably best associated with Jamaica right now. That wasn't always the case. They've been around forever. The ancient Egyptians wore them, and so did the Asian emperors of history. Among the people who have worn them were Germanic tribes. They say that Samson wore them, and then John the Baptist. King Tut had dreadlocks. You don't believe me? Go to the museum. They're still there today. You can read about dreadlocks in the Bible. You might be interested in making some dreadlocks of your own. There's a lot of ways to do it. You can use the backcombing method or the twisting method. I personally prefer the twist and rip method. Here's what you do. You're gonna need some dread wax, some residue-free shampoo, and some rubber bands. You gotta section your hair into 1-inch by 1-inch pieces. You can use rubber bands to hold the sections while you work on the rest of your hair. When you're washing your hair, rub your head in a clockwise motion. Once you get out of the shower and your hair is dry, pull your hair apart in the sections where the rubber bands are. After you've pulled apart the sections, take a little bit of wax, apply it to each dread, and roll it in your palm. The more you twist it back and forth, the faster the dreads will form and lock up. You're looking good.
Are you the key master?
Not that I know of.
Sometimes keys come 88 at a time, like in this song by Groovy Joe Poovy, kind of a rockabilly piano bass version of Johnny B. Good. Here he is, from Dallas, Texas, Groovy Joe Poovy, with 10 long fingers on 88 keys.
On a 88. Just like Johnny B. Good, his name is up in the lights, pounding at the dance on a Saturday night. He don't use so much of music, just a bass and guitar, but people's coming from near and far. When he plays, make me weak and the knees bound, his hand and long fingers on a 88. Now Mr. Cherry Lee ain't got a thing on his boy, 'cause when he plays he really splits joy. He don't dig the music like he plays. Gets his kicker saying, great balls of fire. Kicks the stool back and he gets up on his feet, playing rock and roll music with that crazy beat. No long blonde girls, he got a long nose. The gals don't care, they dig the way he shows. Ripper, rapper, ripper, rapper, ripping up the keys, a pounding 10 long fingers on the 88 keys. Thank you.
music like you play in a choir. He gets his kick of singing great balls of fire. Kicks a stool back and he gets up on his feet, playing rock and roll music with that crazy beat. No long gone girl, he got a long up nose. The gals don't care, they dig the way that he shows. Ripper, rapper, ripper, rapper, ripping up the keys, a pounding ten long fingers on the 88.
That's Groovy Joe Poovy, 10 long fingers on 88 keys. For your math buffs out there, that's 8.8 keys per finger. There's a number of famous people who were named Key. Paul Exel, y'all remember Francis Scott Key? He wrote the Star Spangled Banner. But did you know his great-great-granddaughter, Kathleen Key, was an actress? She had a well-known affair with old Stoneface himself, Buster Keaton, back in the 20s. Want to get a look at her? Look at Ben-Hur, the silent version. She's not Ben, and she's not her. She plays Terza in that movie. Let us not forget the fiscally prudent, Harvard-educated Ellen Keys. And of course, I would be remiss if I did not mention Alicia Keys.
Need to get a copy of this key real quick.
Wait a minute. This is a Medico key. Only a Medico locksmith can make a copy of this. And only with the permission of the key owner.
This is Theme Time Radio Hour. While we're on the subject of locks and keys, here's a poem that Carlos Santana gave me. Doubt is the lock, faith is the key. Hate is the lock and love is the key. Body is the lock, soul is the key. Ignorance is the lock, light is the key. God's heart has no lock, man's mind has no key. Sri Jimnoy, difficult to pronounce poet. Thanks, Carlos. I ran into Amy Sedaris. I told her we were doing a show about locks and keys, and she had some opinions.
I don't keep anything under lock and key. I have this coffin that I had made when my first rabbit died, and I still write her little letters, and I keep it in her little box that I had hand-painted, you know? And it's not locked, but it's the most private thing that I own. I just like the idea of a safe behind a painting or something. I think it'd be fun, but what would I put in it? My ovaries are buried in the backyard. They're in a jar. I'll go get them.
Thanks, Amy. Well, here's another example of a guy from Louisiana. Henry Allen is one of the last great New Orleans trumpet players. He was overshadowed by Louis, but he actually had a fresh approach. In the 60s, he was still playing, and Don Ellis called him the most creative and avant-garde trumpet player in New York. He played in Louis' band for a while, and he also was signed to the Victor label as a rival to Louis when Louis was on OK. He performed with Cy Oliver and Clarence Williams. Here he is, Red Allen, who stole the lock on the hen house door.
On the hen house door. I'm gonna find out before I go. Who stole the lock on the hen house door? Down the hen house on my knees. By the way, the chicken feed. Nothing but the rooster sang his best. Singing love to the hen upstairs. Thank you.
Red Allen, who stole the lock on the hen house door.
Look a here, son. I say, son, did you see that hawk after those hens? He scared them. That Rhode Island red turned white, then blue. Rhode Island, red, white, and blue. That's a joke, son. A flag waver. You're built too low. The fast ones go over your head. You got a hole in your glove. I keep pitching them, and you keep missing them. You got to keep your eye on the ball. Eye, ball. Eyeball! I almost had a gag, son. Joke, that is.
If you really want to lock up the hen house, he has some breakthroughs in modern lock technology. There's locksmith-restricted interactive keyways, or there's factory-restricted keyways. I recommend the Schlage Primus or the Abloy ProTec. What I like about that one is that it has 11 separate discs, which means there are 1.97 billion key combinations possible. And yes, I said billion. And of course, there's a current biometric security that's got your typical encrypted fingerprint recognition, retina iris scanning, and voice verification. One kind of key you'll find in the zoo is a monkey. And here's a song written by Clarence Williams, who we just talked about because he played with Red Allen. It shows you how close Western swing and jazz were. Clarence was a jazz guy, and the original version of this was recorded by a jazz band. But here's Milton Berle and his musical brownies. You don't get more Western swing than this. Doing the Clarence Williams song, he bounds to look like a monkey.
I can tell by your face you belong to the monkey race. You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. When you grow old.
When you grow old.
When you grow old.
When you grow old.
You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. Yeah, boy. I can tell by your hands that you have monkey glands. You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. When you grow old.
When you grow old.
When you grow old.
When you grow old.
You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. Climbing coconut trees, you're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. When you grow old.
When you grow old.
When you grow old.
When you grow old.
You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. I can tell by your chin that you've been drinking gin. You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old.
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 You're
bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. I can tell by your nails that your folks hung by their tails. You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old.
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 You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old.
That was Milton Berle and the Musical Brownies. You're bound to look like a monkey when you grow old. The first monkey in space was Gordo. He was a squirrel monkey sent up by the United States. He went up in 1958. He did fine in space, but upon re-entry, his rocket dropped in the South Atlantic, and he was never found. Some say he's now 40 feet tall and living under the ocean. Since we're talking about keys today, I asked Luke Wilson what he does with his. Here's what he told me.
Yeah, Bob, I forget my keys all the time. I've tried the fake rock, I've tried over the doorway, I've tried under the doormat, but I find what works is that there's kind of an attractive older woman down the street, so I gave her a spare key, so when I forget mine, I just call her. It works out pretty good for both of us.
Thanks, Luke. Well, we got time for just one more, and this one was written by Pop Staples, and the Staples Singers recorded it for VJ. I'm sure if I'm wrong, Tim will be calling back. Here's a band from Detroit with their version of it. Features lead singer, Rachel Nagy. She used to be an exotic dancer. And like Poto Wagner, she used to earn her living as a butcher. Here's her and Maribel Restrepo on guitar and the rest of the band, the Detroit Cobras, and You Don't Knock.
You don't knock.
You don't knock. Just walk on in.
The door. Walk on in.
That was the Detroit Cobras, and You Don't Knock, you just walk on in. You might see a guy up there, his name's Peter, but they call him St. Peter. He was the first apostle. Peter is known as the keeper of the key to heaven's gate. He denied Jesus 3 times, but when Jesus was resurrected, Peter was the first to see him. Peter is known as the patron saint of bakers, butchers, masons, clockmakers, and people with foot problems. I hope you don't have to go see St. Peter too soon, because we hate to lose a single listener. So with any luck, you won't be heading up to the pearly gates, and we'll see you again next week with another hour of themes, dreams, and schemes. Gonna leave you with the words of Walt Whitman's In Prison Soul. At the last, tenderly, from the walls of the powerful fortressed house, from the clasp of the knitted locks, from the keep of the well-closed doors, let me be wafted. Let me glide noiselessly forth. With the key of softness, unlock the locks with a whisper. Set up the door, O soul. Tenderly, be not impatient. Strong is your hold, O mortal flesh. Strong is your hold, O love. Walt Whitman, safe cracker of the soul. We'll see you next week.